Hey guys, Kevin here, day 45. Up today, we're gonna cover the head stall. So if you like the video, please leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, hit that bell notification button. Also try and watch as much of the video as possible if you enjoy it. That really helps the channel out. Basic gist of head stall, I'll show you in the other videos, but you wanna get your feet roughly shoulder width apart. Have a slight bend in your knees while you're practicing it as well. This just allows you to gain a little bit of movement and a good solid base. What you're going to do is with a head stall, the head stall isn't here in between your nose. When I teach a lot of people, they want to do it here. That's technically a nose stall. It's here. I'm going to come a bit closer. So it's here where your head curves and where your head curves here and the forehead meets the hairline. That's a great ideal place. Get your ball to start with and you're just going to place it on top in that position. Keep your eyes on the ball. And just try and hold it. I held it for around a second or so there. When you first put it on, it's probably just going to come off. So don't worry about that. It takes patience and practice. Hold it on. And then try and adjust to the movements of the ball. So when the ball starts to move, you want to try and move with it. Slowly at first, just to get the time and try and build your time up. So start trying to go for a couple of seconds, then try and build up to 5 or 10 seconds until you get a good comfortable balance and you can hold it a little longer. Then. Now you want to progress it. And you want to progress it to throwing the ball up, and it's the same kind of thing we did with the next stall where we threw the ball up. You want to throw it up. Now this is where the knee bend comes in a little bit. You want to get a good position with your feet, a slight knee bend as you go to meet the ball, but keep your eyes on the ball again. And again, same, start with a little chuck, just try and chuck it on top of your head. Aim for just above here, and you might have to slightly duck under to meet the ball. Sometimes if you throw it harder, it's going to kind of bounce off your head. It's going to happen. So just meet and adjust to it. And again, it's the same. Just keep practicing it over and over until you can build your time up. From there, you want to do it from a foot stall. I've recorded that bit, so I'll show you that bit there, but basically a foot stall and throw it up. As you throw it up from the foot stall, it's the same principle, eyes on, until you can hold it. And it's going to take your time to build up. You're going to let the ball's going to fall off, just keep putting it back on. Personally, I have a love-hate relationship with uppers because they take a lot of dedicated practice to get good at them. And it's same again, obviously with kick-ups, the ball might bounce off your head a bit, so get used to bouncing it and balancing it as well. And that's where a good core position in your knees bent comes in. It takes time, learning it different ways, but just practice, practice, practice. One variation I like to do, and I'll just show it you. From a finger spin. So when you get your ball up, and it just adds a whole new dimension to trying to balance it, because you've got to get used to the spin of the ball and then that. Anyway guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please leave a like, comment, share, subscribe, hit that bell notification button to stay up to date with the videos, and I'll see you again tomorrow.